Next, write down. Next, metamers. Write down. These are the compounds. These are the compounds which has different group present. These are the compounds which has different group present. Around the polyvalent functional group, around the polyvalent functional group. Next slide. This is only possible in, only possible with the functional group, with the functional group which has valency greater than or equal to 2, greater than or equal to 2. So polyvalent functional group is required for this kind of isomerism. Polyvalent functional group means what? The valency is 2 or more. For example, you see ether, 2 open bond we have, valency is 2. But if you talk about aldehyde, C double bond OH, it is monovalent, only one bond is open. Ketone also possible. Aldehyde won't show. Aldehyde cannot show metamerism, right? Ketone is also a polyvalent functional group, right? Thioether also a polyvalent functional group. Amines are also a polyvalent functional group. Okay? We can also take C double bond O, O R group present. This is also a polyvalent functional group. Okay? So this R you can exchange. You don't write this. Ester may show, right? Or you can explain. I'll give you the example here. Right? Now suppose the molecule is this CH3CH2. OCH2CH3. What is the name of this compound? Diethyl ether. Right? Diethyl ether. What about this one? CH3O CH2CH2CH3. What is the name of this compound? Methyl propyl ether. So they have same molecular formula.
Yeah.
Right?
Don't keep calling it propyl.
No. Methanoid will use in ester, not in ether. It is C double bond O OR.
Yes.
Correct. Name is methyl propyl ether diethyl ether. Same molecular formula, right? But the alkyl group across the polyvalent functional group, which is oxygen here, ether. Here we have ethyl ethyl, here we have methyl and propyl. So different alkyl group is present, so these two are metamers of each other. Right? Ketone, they include double bond O. What is the name of this compound? Pentane 3-on. What about this one? Pentane 2-on. So position is what? Here it is 3, here it is 2. You can ask me why this is not positional isomers. Right? We can say it is positional isomers if metamers is not there in the option. So priority is what? First metamers. If metamers is given, their metamers, otherwise we will take positional isomers, right? Because the definition of metamers is more specific here. Okay? So these two are, preferably we will say, these two are metamers of each other. If metamers is not given in the option, then we will go with positional isomers, correct? So write down here. If metamers is not given in the option, then we'll consider these as positional isomers. Positional isomers. You see this example again? This side we have phenyl, this side we have cyclohexane. If you exchange these two,
I need to
These two are again metamers. So ester can also show metamers. Alkyl alkanoid.
Cyclohexyl
benzenoid. It is what? It is benzyl cyclohexanoid. No, just a second. No, it's not. This is a substituent, right? This is one carbon and this is one carbon. So it is cyclohexyl phenyl methanoid. Cyclohexyl phenyl methanoid. Ring or acyclic chain, both we cannot consider. Here also it is benzyl cyclohexyl methanoid.
But so there's two metamers.
Ah, metamers, fine. Name is this, they are metamers. Correct.
Cyclohexyl benzyl methanoid.
Yes. No, not phenol. Cyclohexyl benzyl methanoid. Why methanoid? Because we have only one carbon. Okay, next write down ring chain isomers. Ring chain. Write down in this type, one of the isomer is acyclic and other one is cyclic. One is open chain, other one is ring structure. Ring chain isomers. Okay. Like propane 2-ohn. Propane 2-ohn is this
ring chain,
right? And this one ring chain isomers of this. Okay, if you take this as propene, right, or cyclopropane, ring chain isomers. You can check the molecular formula is same for these compounds. Okay, any other example? What if we take aldehyde here? CH3, CH2, this spell right now. Double bond O and H. These two are also ring chain isomers. These two are also ring chain isomers. So one compound is acyclic, another one is cyclic. Anything other is left in this? We have done structural of what else we have done? Tautomerism.
That is
the only thing left. No.
Yeah.
Okay, tautomerism we'll do it in the last. Okay. Achha, isomerism, we have done only resonance. No. So tautomerism cursor. So we'll do that.
Sir,
so
that one is oxacyclobutane.
Oxacyclobutane, yes. Okay. Write down tautomerism. Write down. This is tautomerism. This is a definition. This is a spontaneous phenomenon. This is a spontaneous phenomenon in which two different compounds exist in dynamic equilibrium. What is dynamic equilibrium?
They're constantly
interchanging. A, B may be same. The reversible reaction is where we have the equilibrium, right? So that is dynamic equilibrium. So you see here, suppose we have this example.
So isn't this just resonance?
It requires conceptual resonance. CH3, C double bond O, CH2, H. Don't ask me why did you write this. CH3 will accept. Okay. So this is what? This is ketone. Right. When you take this compound into a, you know, suppose a container or a vessel, you have pure this compound you have taken, right? Okay, so initially it is 100% because we have only acetone or this molecule present in the vessel, right? 100%. After some time, if you measure the percentage content of it, it's important hai, bahut exam mein aaye, theek hai, bahut kuch hai. समझने की कोशिश करो, बातें करोगे फिर से भूल लो. ओके, व्हाटएवर वी हैव डन सो फार, दिस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इन स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ आइसोमर्स. okay, or its application in organic chemistry will get everywhere. So this is initially 100%. After some time, suppose 5-10 minutes, if you measure the composition of this, it won't be 100% because some part of it will convert into this molecule, which is CH3COH, double bond CH2. Okay? This we call it as enol. En and ol. En stands for this double bond and ol for this OH. Right? This is keto enol tautomerism, we call it. Okay? It is keto enol tautomerism. Because the conversion of keto into enol takes place. This happens spontaneously. We are not doing anything into it. En and ol. This side is enol. Double bond, so en, OH, so ol. Enol, right? So it is. So it is keto enol tautomerism. What happens here? Because of this electron withdrawing nature of this group, these hydrogens are acidic hydrogens. Okay? So this hydrogen has tendency to come out as H plus, right? So when this comes out as H plus, what happens here you see, CH3C double bond O, CH2 and negative charge. H plus comes out, so you get this. And this happens on its own because the process is spontaneous, right? Now we can draw the resonating structure here because it is in resonance. Conjugation is there. So when you draw the resonating structure, you get CH3 CO minus double bond CH2. So you see we have two different sites where this H plus has a tendency to attach. Actually ye H plus pehle nikalta hai and then it also wants to attach on the molecule. But when it comes out, this molecule, some part of this molecule converts into this due to resonance.
Charges is flowing.
Right. This H plus comes out, you get this. Now when this H plus wants to attach again on the given molecule, some part of it in between, meanwhile, it converts into this. Now it has two different sites. This H plus can attach on this carbon also and this oxygen also. So if this H plus attached onto this oxygen, you will end up getting this molecule. Right? And if this H plus attached onto this, you will get the original molecule. Right? So the one which is more stable, that will only form as a major product in this reaction.
So here which one is?
Ketone is generally more stable. C double bond, O bond strength is higher than... First this and then this one. These are intermediates. Won't be as a product. You have this and this, the mixture of these two in the product. Okay? So there are various factor we have which stabilizes these two. So we'll see that later. One note you write down here. One note you write down.
Why does the H come out of the compound?
Because of the electron withdrawing nature of it. The carbon hydrogen bond becomes very weak and then it comes out. Basically, it facilitates the acidic behavior of this.
So, what process is the ketone under?
It is keto enol tautomerism.
So, but then how is it changed to enol?
That's what I said. Because of electron withdrawing nature of this, this hydrogen becomes acidic. Right? So it has tendency to come out as H plus. However, it is not as strong as it, but some H plus will come out. When this H plus comes out, it converts into this, which forms this as a resonating structure. And then H plus. See, it is just for your understanding. Actually, tautomerism, one point to write down, it is possible in both acidic or basic medium. It is possible in both acidic and basic medium. So next class, we'll see the mechanism first. Okay, we'll see the mechanism first in both the medium and we'll see how to decide which product is the major product in various different. No. Correct?